Hello everyone, I am Trupti Pandya and today I will be teaching you Element of Account Standard 12 Part 2 Chapter 2 Accounting for Debenture. Introduction. Normally the company issued share capital for the requirement of long-term funds. Sometimes in addition to share capital, if a company requires more fund than this fund can be met by loan or borrowed amount. Financially sound companies get long-term loan from bank or financial institutions. Mostly, instead of borrowing such a loan from financial institutions or in addition to borrowing such a loan for large investments, company can raise funds from public by issue of securities. Such a security is popularly known as a debenture or bond. Companies carrying on a business have the inherent power of authority to borrow money. Based on this inherent power, companies borrow long-term funds from the public. Against the money show borrowed or investment, the company issues a document or certificate acknowledging its debt to the investor. Such a certificate is known as a debenture. Those who get the debentures by giving money to the company or have purchased from the market are known as a holder of the debenture or debenture holder. Debenture holder is not considered as the owner of the company. Debenture shareholder, if a share is there, then shareholder is the owner of the company. But debenture holder is not considered as the owner of the company. Debenture is a document that confirms the debt of the company and its acknowledgement of the debt. It is issued under the common seal of the company. Company has to pay interest at a specified rate and on specified time on the amount invested by debenture holder in the company in the accordance with the agreed term. It is an expense for the company and is income for debenture holder. The company repays the money borrowed against a debenture at a future date as per the terms of issue of debentures to the holder of the debentures. A certificate which is issued to debenture holder by company contains name of debenture holder, name of debenture, amount per debenture, serial number of debentures, rate of interest payable, time for payment of interest, and also shows when the debenture money will be paid at a future date. In present scenario, a debenture certificate is issued to debenture holder in dematerializations from instead of a physical copy. It means purchase of debenture is directly credited to demat account of a debenture holders. By allotment letters, company informs the debenture holders about how many debentures are allotted to them, its number and amount, and also conditions for debentures. Important points relating to debenture. First, debenture is a document relating to the money lent or given as a loan to the company. It means debenture is a document that confirms the debt of the company. Second, debenture is a security that bears a fixed rate of interest on which the interest is payable on predetermined date. Company has to pay the interest on the debentures even if it is earned profit or not earned profit. Third, interest on debentures is payable at a fixed rate, and so debentures are known by the rate. As example, if interest is payable at the rate 8% per annum on debentures, then it is known as or written as 8% debentures. Fourth, when debentures are issued for a fixed term, the money borrowed against such debentures is repaid at the end of fixed term in accordance with the agreed terms. If it is given for five years, 3 years, after 3 years or after 5 years, repaid this amount with the agreed terms. Fifth one, as per Companies Act 2013, no company is allowed to issue debentures having a maturity date of more than 10 years from the date of issue. However, a company engaged in infrastructure projects can issue debentures for more than 10 years but not exceeding 30 years. Sixth one, debentures can be issued with or without charge on the asset of the company. Charge on the asset means mortgage or hypothecation. 7th one, usually debentures are listed on the stock exchange after the issue thereof, and purchase or sale of debentures are traded at the stock exchanges. The market value of such debentures could be more or less than the price of the issue. 8th one, if the terms of the issue of a debenture so provide, the debentures can be converted into shares. 9th one, debentures are shown as long-term borrowing under the heading non-current liabilities on equity and liability side in the balance sheet. 10th one, debenture holder do not have any voting right in any matter of the company. 11th, debentures cannot be forfeited if any debenture holder does not pay any amount on debenture. 12th one, in the event of the liquidation of a company, the debenture holders are repaid their money before the payment of equity shareholder. Now, third point, types of debenture. Classification of debenture is made as under. First, A, on the basis of a security. First, secured or mortgage debenture. When this type of debentures are issued, some or all of the assets of the company are given as a security. In other words, a charge is created on the assets of the company. Such a charge could be of two types. Fixed charge, in this only, some assets of the company are given as a security, and floating charge, in which usually all the assets of a company are given as a security. If the company is unable to repay the debenture on the due date, then the debenture holders are repaid the amount from the money realized on the sale of a mortgage asset. First mortgage debentures are those that have a first claim on the assets charged. Second mortgage debenture are those having a second claim after first mortgage debenture on the asset charged. Second is unsecured or a simple or naked debenture. Such a debenture are issued without giving any security or creating any charge on the asset of the company. From the investor's viewpoint, such debentures are risky. So such a type of debentures are not very common. The holder of the such debenture are treated as unsecured creditors at the time of liquidation of the company. B, second type, as per negotiability and procedure for redemption. First, registered debenture. The company maintains a register of debenture holders. The register contains the name, address, and other particulars related to debenture holders. The transfer of such debentures requires the executions of a proper transfer deed to give entry to company's register. Principal amount and interest on such a debenture is paid to the person whose name appears in the company's register. Bearer debenture. There is no need for any procedure for the transfer of such debentures with the company. The purchaser has to make a payment to the seller of the debentures and take the delivery of the debentures. Thus, bearer debentures are like currency notes and can be transferred by mere delivery. The person who possesses such debentures enjoys all the rights thereof. The interest coupons are attached with debentures. Certificate for periodic interest payment on such debentures and such coupons are like checks or orders for payment of interest, which can be encashed by debenture holder through the prescribed bank by the company on due dates for the payment of interest. Third type, as per condition of redemption. First, redeemable debenture. The debentures which are issued with a condition that the amount of a debenture can be repaid after a certain periods are known as a redeemable debenture. This amount will be repaid in a lump sum or by installment. The period of redemption is stated in the debenture or a trust deed. Second, perpetual or irredeemable debenture. Irredeemable debenture are those debentures which are not repayable by the company during its lifetime. Generally, this type of debentures are repayable only at the time of liquidation of the company. Fourth, on the basis of conditions for convertibility. First, convertible debenture. Convertible debentures are those debentures which are convertible into equity shares or other securities at a stated rate of exchange, either at the option of a debenture holder or at the option of the company after specified period. When only a part of the amount of debenture is convertible into shares, such debentures are called partly convertible debentures. When the full amount of debenture is convertible into shares, such debentures are called fully convertible debentures. Convertible debentures are very popular in present times as they provide liquidity, safety, capital appreciation and assured return to the investor. Next, non-convertible debenture. Such debentures cannot be converted into shares or any other security. Procedure for issue of debenture. How to issue the debenture? When company has decided to issue debentures, a resolution is passed at the meeting of board of directors of the company. The resolutions should state the number of debentures, amount per debenture and also total amount of debenture issued, rate of interest thereon, date of redemption and other terms related to the issue of the debentures. Second, Companies Act and provision of SEBI should be considered at the time of issue of a debenture. A company should issue a prospectus or a statement in lieu of the prospectus with proper information inviting the public to subscribe for debentures. Third, the procedure for the issue of debentures is very much similar to that of issue of shares. Company has to prepare a separate application form for the public to subscribe for debentures. Fourth, allotment of debentures should be equal the number of issued debentures against the number of debentures application received. For this, company has to open separate bank account in any CDR bank. Fifth one, as per rule of Companies Act 2013, minimum subscription should be 90% of the issued amount. Sixth one, full amount of debentures may be called by the company on application or may be called in installments. Seventh one, when debentures are issued to the public subscription, then money received on this has to be kept in a scheduled bank in a separate account. So money received on application at the time of debentures subscription has to be kept directly in a separate bank account like subscription of a shares. After subscription or issue is closed, allotment letter is sent to applicants to whom debentures were allotted and debenture application money is refunded to those applicants to whom debenture were not allotted. Eighth one, debentures may be issued either at par, at a premium or at a discount. Like a share, three situations are there. At par means same as face value, at a premium means more amount and at discount means less amount. Shares cannot be issued at a discount as a sweat equity share, but a debenture can be issued at a discount. The rate of a premium or discount is to be decided by directors. Now, fifth point, accounting effect for issue of a debenture. When issue the debenture at that time, which type of accounting effects are there? Procedure, transactions and name of account for issue of debentures are the same as share capital transactions. Such as a debenture application account, debenture allotment account and debenture call accounts, etc. Debenture percentage is always mentioned before the word debenture. Following accounting entries will be passed in the books of company on the issue of a debenture under different circumstances. First, issue of debenture at par means at the same as the face value. When the full amount of debenture is called up at a time, bank account debit to days percentage debenture application and allotment account. Second, days percent debenture application and allotment account debit to days percent debenture account. For example, a company issued 8,009% debenture for 100 rupees each. The full amount on debenture was called up on application it was received. Bank account debit 8 lakh, 8,000 into 100, 8 lakh to 9% debenture application and allotment account 8 lakh. Being application money fully received on 8,000 debenture at rupees 100 per debenture. 9% debenture application and allotment account debit 8 lakh to 9% debenture account 8 lakh. Being application money transferred to debentures account. When the full amount of debentures is called up at the time of application, and then that amount will be credited to debenture application allotment account. When the amount of debenture is called up in installment. Following entries will be passed on the issue of debenture. Here assume that the debenture carry 9% interest. On receipt of application money, bank account debit to 9% debenture application account, being application money received. On transfer of application money to debenture account, it means allotment of a debenture. 9% debenture application account debit to 9% debenture account, being allotment of debenture. On refund of money to applications rejected to rejected applicants. 9% debenture application account debit to bank account, being application money refund returned to applicants on reject the applications. Fourth one, on transfer of surplus application money on partially accepted application. 9% debenture application account debit to 9% debenture allotment account, being excess application money transferred to allotment account. When allotment money due, 9% debenture allotment account debit to 9% debenture account, being allotment money due. Sixth one, on receipt of allotment money, bank account debit to 9% debenture allotment account, being allotment money received. When amount due on call, 9% debenture call account debit to 9% debenture account, being respective call amount due on debentures. On receipt of call money, bank account debit to 9% debenture call account, being money received on calls on debentures. Let us understand the above journal entries with the help of following illustration. Illustration number 1. Ashok Mills Limited issue 8000 debentures of rupees 100 each for public subscription. Interest is to be paid at the rate of 8% per annum on debentures. The amount were called up per debenture as under. With application rupees 30, on allotment rupees 40, on call rupees 30. Applications were received by company of rupees 10,000 debentures. After allotment of 8,000 debentures, rejected excess application of debentures and refunded the money to applicants. All the amounts due on allotment and call were duly received. Write journal entries in the book of company. Journal entries in the book of Ashok Mills Limited. Bank account debit 3 lakh to 8% debenture application account 3 lakh. Being receipt of application money on 10,000 debentures at 30 per debenture. 8% debenture application account debit 3 lakh to 8% debenture account 2,40,000 to bank account 60,000. Being transfer money debenture account on allotment 8,000 debenture and money on reject 2,000 debenture. 2,000 debenture rejected and 8,000 debenture transfer into debenture application account. 8% debenture allotment account debit 3,20,000 to 8% debenture account 3,20,000. Being allotment money due on 8,000 debentures at rupees 40 per debenture. Bank account debit 3,20,000 to 8% debenture allotment account 3,20,000. Being receipt of full amount of allotment money. Now 8% debenture call account debit 2,40,000 to 8% debenture account 2,40,000. Being call money due on 8,000 debentures at rupees 30 per debenture. Bank account debit 2,40,000 to 8% debenture call account 2,40,000. Being receipt of a full amount on call money on debenture. Now second situation. Issue of debentures at a premium means more amount than face value. When the debentures are issued at more than their face value, they are said to have been issued at a premium. For example, if debenture of rupees 100 is debentures price of rupees 100 is issued at rupees 130, then it is called this debenture issued at a premium of rupees 30. As per Companies Act 2013, premium amount on debenture is transferred to security premium reserve account. Like said premium, debenture premium is also a capital profit and hence the same cannot be used for distribution of a dividend but can be used for writing of capital expenses or loss like a discount on issue of debentures, premium on reduction of debentures, preliminary expense, goodwill, patent, etc. Security premium reserve account is shown on the equity and liability side of the balance sheet under the head of reserve and surplus. When the full amount of the debenture is called up at time, for example, a company issued 6,010% debenture of rupees 100 each at a premium of rupees 20 per debenture. The full amount of debenture was called up on application on all the debentures and the same was received. The journal entry in the books of the company will be as under. Bank account debit 7,20,000 to 10% debenture application and allotment account 7,20,000. Being receipt of application money on 6,000 debentures at rupees 120 per debenture. 10% debenture application and allotment account debit 7,20,000 to 10% debenture account 6,00,000 to security premium reserve 1,20,000. Being application money transferred to debenture account and premium account. When the amount of debenture is called up in installment. Illustration number 2. Gujarat Limited issued 5,010% debentures of rupees 200 each premium of 20% on which the amount per debenture was called up as under. Rupees 60 on application, rupees 100 on allotment including premium, rupees 80 on final call. Applications were received for a total of 8,000 debentures. From these, access applications were rejected and refunded the money received thereon. All the amounts due on allotment and call were duly received. Past journal entries in the books of the company. Journal of Gujarat Limited. Bank account debit 4,80,000 to 10% debenture application account 4,80,000. Being application money received on 8,000 debenture at rupees 60 per debenture. Second, 10% debenture application account debit 4,80,000 to 10% debenture account 3,00,000 to bank account 1,80,000. Being money on 5,000 allotted debentures transferred to debenture account and money on 3,000 rejected debentures refunded to applicants. Third one, 10% debenture allotment account debit 5,00,000 to 10% debenture account 3,00,000 to security premium reserve account 2,00,000. Being amount due on allotment including premium rupees 100 per debenture. Bank account debit 5,00,000 to 10% debenture allotment account 5,00,000. Being receipt of a full amount of allotment money due. 10% debenture final account debit 4,00,000 to 10% debenture account 4,00,000. Being amount due on final call at rupees 80 per debenture. Bank account debit 4,00,000 to 10% debenture final call account 4,00,000. Being full amount received on final call. Now third situation, issue of debenture at discount. When the company issues debenture at price which is less than their face value or nominal value, the debentures are said to have been issued at a discount. For example, a debenture of rupees 100 face value is issued at rupees 90. Here rupees 10 would be discount. Amount of discount on debenture is debited to discount on debenture account. There is no restrictions in the Companies Act as regards the maximum discount which can be given in the issue of the debenture. If there is no restrictions in the Articles of Association of the company, debentures can be issued at a discount. If there is no clarifications, discount on debenture is recorded at the time of debenture allotment entry. Amount of debenture discount or loss on issue of debenture is shown in the balance sheet. As per Accounting Standard 26, debenture discount amount is shown under different heads, which depends on the terms of debenture. Let us understand this by an illustration. One example is that amount of discount on debenture is 2,40,000. It is to be returned off in 6 years. Here 2,40,000 divided by 6 is equal to 40,000 for each year. 40,000 rupees debited to current year statement of profit and loss. Remaining amount 2,00,000 is shown under the head non-current asset and subhead other non-current asset in the balance sheet. How to show amount of discount on the debentures in the balance sheet is not in syllabus. So this type of question are not be asked in the exam for writing of discount on issue of debenture. discount or loss on issue of debenture is a capital loss. It should be written off as early as possible, but within the lifetime of the debentures. As example, if debenture issued at a discount with a condition that debentures are redeemed after 6 years, then the period of writing off total amount of discount should not be more than 6 years. Usually this amount is written off against security premium reserve account of a statement of profit or loss for this following journal entries to be passed. Security premium reserve account debit or a statement of a profit or loss account debit to discount on debenture or loss on issue of debenture account. When the full amount of the debenture is called up at the time, for example, a company issued 2008% debenture of rupees 100 each at a price of rupees 80 per debenture, on which the full amount was called up and the same was received. The journal entry in the books of the company will be as under: bank account debit 1,60,000 to debenture application and allotment account 1,60,000, being application money received on 2000 debenture at rupees 80 per debenture. Debenture application and allotment account debit 1,60,000, discount on debenture account debit 40,000 to 8% debenture account 2 lakh, being issue of 2008% debenture of rupees 100 each at a discount of rupees 20 per debenture. When the amount of a debenture is called up in installment. Illustration number 3. Rajkot Oil Limited issues 8,010% debenture of rupees 100 each at a price of rupees 90 per debenture. The amount per debenture was payable as under: rupees 30 with application, rupees 40 can allotment after discount, and rupees 20 on call. The company received application of 8,000 debentures. The company received the full money called on allotment, except on 300 debentures. The company received full amount due on call. Pass necessary journal entries in the books of a company. Bank account debit 2,40,000 to 10% debenture application account 2,40,000, being allotment money received on 8,000 debenture at rupees 30 per debenture. 10% debenture application account debit 2,40,000 to 10% debenture account 2,40,000, being application money transferred to debenture amount. 10% debenture allotment account debit 3,20,000, discount on debenture account debit 80,000 to 10% debenture account 4 lakh, being allotment money due on 40 per debenture after a discount rupees 10. Bank account debit 3,20,000 to 10% debenture allotment account 3,20,000, being receipt of full amount of allotment money due. 10% debenture final call account debit 1,60,000 to 10% debenture account 1,60,000, being final call amount due on 8,000 debenture at rupees 20 per debenture. Bank account debit 1,54,000, call in arrears on debenture account 6,000 to 10% debenture call account 1,60,000, being call money received on 7,700 debentures and call money not received on 300 debentures. So this waiver illustration number 3 is over. Thank you very much.